If you're here to go postal, kill me first. I hate this job.
Girl, no, you ain't worth going back to jail.
But why are you here in this whack cat suit?
Now, this is fierce, honey. Beyonce wore this in her last video.
And you know what? Are you crazy? Do you know the hell? Give me this bag. Do you know the hell Uncle Dale's been putting me through trying to find these gum wrappers and napkins? It's been you that's been coming up in the office, taking all the office supplies.
Well, it was right there in plain sight, jammed behind the toilet in the men's bathroom.
Honey, have you been coming up in here every night trying to screw things up?
I do miss my daily hustle.
You must get tired of standing on those street corners.
You know what? You're trying.
That was really funny, but yeah, you stupid.
But you know, this was my first real job, and you know, this became more to me than that. Mr. Jones is like family to me.
Well, maybe if you just apologize.
Apologize? Girl, no.
We just know that bastard.
Well, talking about, and you just got finished saying that he's like family.
No, I was talking about that Uncle Tom turkey ass client.
Uncle Dale's gonna hire somebody else, and he's gonna bring them up in here to replace you.
So? Okay.
I mean, I do, but who cares?
Well, they're gonna have a hell of a time finding the restroom key. Cause I'm out.
So, do you have any experience in the real estate business?
Kinda. No, not really, no.
Oh. You know, I'm really very impressed by your resume. But aren't you a little overqualified for this position?
Yes. But my husband retired, my kid moved back home. I kicked the cat yesterday. It could be menopause, but my dreams are becoming increasingly more violent.
What are you doing here?
You got a real nice situation going on down here, and I want in.
If you want to call my references.
Is it hot in here?
I'm sorry, I forgot the question.
My therapist thought getting out of the house would be a good idea, and I thought I should run her over with my car. Listen, I gotta pick up my nephew from the hospital. Did I get the job or not?
If you don't have me, I might have to move back east and work for my uncle. He works in a hospital maternity ward, sweeping up after circumcisions. He says it doesn't pay a lot, but every customer leaves a tip. Wait for it.
I'm a real people person. I always carry around a notepad. Fewer mistakes that way. The last real estate office that I worked for was much bigger, but it lacked that personal touch. Plus, you're really close to home, and I've always wanted to work in my own community.
You're perfect. Your recommendations are stellar, and, well, I knew your last employer very well.
He speaks very highly of you.
So, do you have any questions?
No. But I am legally obligated to inform you that I'm a registered sex offender.
Thank you for your time.
Oh, isn't this nice? The three amigos.
All right, Onini. What's it gonna take?
1 hour lunch.
45 minutes.
Deal. And the calls go to voicemail?
That's fair. You make the coffee.
Oh, I'll make the coffee.
I wouldn't drink that coffee.
I'll learn to make the coffee. We cool?
Be cool. Yes.
And now things can go back to normal.
Where you do as little as possible.
That's right.
Oh, and one last thing, Mr. Jones.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
I just think you owe me an apology for all that Mr. Barnes stuff. You know he's the reason you fired me.
No. I fired you because you were out of line.
Oh. Is that the way you say it? Okay, then. I quit.
I took your advice. I quit. Deuces.
That's not exactly how I meant it.
I'm unique. What are you doing?
That man came in here and embarrassed me, and Mr. Jones didn't say nothing.
I've been down for you since day one. And you let that bigot come up in here and tell you that I was nothing, and you believed him.
I'm unique.
Say it ain't so. Mr. Jones, excuse my language, but that Mr. Barnes is a fake.
What did I call him earlier?
And Uncle Tom, turkey ass.
Yes, that Uncle Tom, turkey ass, had you all messed up. He clouded your judgment and made you forget where you came from. And ain't nobody got time for that. I'm out. Aren't you gonna stop her?
No. Hello.
Oh, welcome to Del Jones Realty. May I help you?
Yes, Mr. Barnes to see Mr. Jones.
Okay, you just have a seat and I'll let Mr. Jones know that you're here.
Thank you.
Mr. Barnes is here to see you. Okay. Mr. Jones will be right out. Can I offer you something to drink?
May you?
May I offer you something to drink? Water or coffee?
Yes, please, coffee. Two sugars and a lot of cream.
Mm-hmm. That sounds about right.
Mr. Barnes, glad you can make it.
I figured since you made the effort, why shouldn't I?
That's very generous of you. Oh, why don't we step into my office?
I'll bring the coffee right in.
Thank you. Have a seat, Mr. Barnes. All right. Let me go over the plan of action for getting your property sold.
Sounds good to me.
Here's your coffee, Mr. Barnes. And is there anything else that I can get you?
No, thank you. That would be all.
You're very welcome.
I must say, Delroy, I like the improvements you've made around here. The whole place seems a bit brighter. More articulate, if you know what I mean.
I know exactly what you mean. Which is exactly why I'm going to have to ask you to get the hell out of my office.
What? Oh, good God, man, you've gone ghetto.
Not quite as ghetto as I could be. You insulted a young, sweet lady, and I impulsively fired her. Who cares if she doesn't enunciate or hold her tongue and has multicolored hair and bad office decor? She deserves to be treated like a decent human being.
Let me guess. Is this because you hung out on the same corners as her more than likely absentee father?
You're damn right. But look at me now. I'm a successful businessman who is not afraid to reach back and help others off that very same street corner. Yet I'm not so far removed that I will not kick your self-loathing, intolerant ass all up and down this block. Now, I'm not going to ask you or ax you, but one more again. Get the hell out of my office, fool.
Get to getting. And see, this way I can set reminders and update your schedule while you're out showing houses.
These smartphones really do come in handy. Huh? Yeah, what about that other thing? Did you,
A download?
Yeah, did you download that?
You know I did.
Show me.
You just go to the app and make your selection and...
When Kiranisha went for her morning pick-me-up, she had no idea she'd find it in a tall, white chocolate cup of love.
Kiranisha be tripping.
Don't she know? Well... let me get back to work. You know, I wouldn't want my boss to think I was goofing off.
I'm glad you're back.
Me too. Oh, and thanks for making the coffee this morning.
It was terrible.
It was awful. But it made me feel needed. And that's nice.